So we've had two wonderful days of conversation among us, CCFR council members, and I think more than ever before, we discussed and thought about how our big concern, which is geopolitics, and not only the survival of Europe and the EU, but is thriving in a rather turbulent world, how this is linked to not just power balances and what's happening out there, but what's happening in the midst of our society, of our politics, how people feel that they're in control of their destiny, that they're all both protected and have opportunities. And all of the angst that we see in our societies reflected in the so-called populist vote. And of course, we were meeting in the context of the Italian turmoil, seeing all of our Italian friends having to depart early to deal with stuff back home in Rome. And so I think in this grand connection between the macro geopolitics and the incredibly micro societal turmoil, we all feel that there's a figure, Emmanuel Macron, who is leading the way, who's really connecting those dots. And in doing so, he's a very inspiring figure for many of us. But at the same time, I would be worried if what we would be saying is, let's follow the leader. He has great idea, he has charisma, he dares. He goes to Germany and says, you know, stop worrying about surplus fetishism, or stop engaging in surplus fetishism in front of Merkel, who doesn't really know what to say. He does these coups, and that's wonderful, and he has a range of proposals, both about the domestic politics and the global, and he goes around the globe representing a new face for Europe. But what we need now in the rest of Europe is other such leaders, not just followers of Macron, leaders who go with him, leaders at the top, but also in the social movement. And we need the bureaucracy, the eurocracy, the technocracy to understand that civil society, parties, movements, groups, NGOs, individuals, through the internet or others, are their force vive. And to connect with them better than in a kind of good old Euro speak way of explaining to the people. That mindset needs to change, and I'm hoping that the Macron phenomenon will, you know, inspire others, each to do it in their own way. And I think our ECFR conversation would be one element in this very big, complicated, but ultimately hugely colorful mosaic of Europe and the world.